I am the future.
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 I can see all the things arresting me, but I control.
Slide High's education program is going to be based on a STEAM program because we feel like high schools nowadays don't have enough career-based programs for kids or enough project-based learning. So STEAM stands for Science and Technology interpreted through Arts and Engineering, and it's all math-based. So the program will work through classes that are like learned through math, but we'll learn more of the engineering and art aspects as well. And it will deviate from most of the normal programs we have in schools today, such as like regular English and regular math or regular social studies. We'll learn all of those, but through different techniques, so kids can use more creativity and ingenuity when they're learning. So we took surveys from our target market, which would be parents and middle schoolers who are thinking about attending a different kind of high school. So when we talked to them, the results came up that a lot of kids would like to learn better public speaking skills and not focus as much on like programs that are talking about things that aren't as much hands-on learning and learning by doing. And we think that the STEAM program helps a lot with that by using the project-based learning. And project-based learning is giving kids more of like a goal instead of just giving them a straightforward assignment. Like they have a certain kind of, there's not as much structure, there's not like any textbook readings or anything. It's like you're doing projects and you're making learning experience through doing exactly what the project entitles you to do. Slide High is going to be the kind of school that has a lottery school because it's a public school, but the class size and the school size are limited. So the school size will be around 800 to 1,000 kids, and the average class size will be around 20 to 30 kids. Also, when kids are picking their scheduling, they have block days on 4 days a week, and then the last day of the week they have all six periods, so kids have six different classes to choose from. And the class requirements aren't as strict as normal classes because you have lots of different programs to choose from, and there's not as many specific just English credits or math credits or history credits that you have to take. You can take different kinds of more specific classes that also count for the same credits. So kids are also going to have a free period every day where it's about an hour long, where kids have the chance to pursue their own endeavors and their own interests and use their time to however they would like to. We have and the design incorporated into it helps that as well.
So when considering a location for our school, we really wanted to find a destination where Slide would thrive and best harness the climate of the Pacific Northwest while contributing to the community. After surveying the Seattle area, we found a location that we think Slide would do very well, which is located in the northeast corner of Seattle, Washington, right off of Lake Washington. The area we chose is in Magnuson Park, which is home to many community facilities, as well as NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. The chosen site for the school falls right in the area currently located by NOAA. Rather than tearing down the NOAA buildings and repositioning them, we decided to build our school on the same site as NOAA and include a shared facility building where we can bring NOAA professionals into our school as well as other professional mentors from the city. Because the location for Slide is in a thriving community, we wanted to make sure that our school did not have any unnecessary facilities that might already be available to students in a nearby radius. So, in order to make sure that we don't double up on any facilities, we created an asset map listing all of the facilities in a 1 mile radius of Slide. After making the asset map, we found that there are many facilities, especially in the athletics field, such as baseball fields, soccer fields, tennis courts, indoor soccer arenas, and a rock climbing wall. And there is also a theater in a nearby facility. As for food production, Magnuson Park has a field on site where they grow their own produce which will be used for our cafeteria and lunch system. Now, as for the energy aspect of our building, Slide High School produces net positive energy, so not only will we produce all of the energy that we need, but we will also give back excess energy to the community. So as I mentioned before, our site will be shared with NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, and because our school has a STEM focus, we really want to use this opportunity as a way to bring these professionals into our school for student knowledge. NOAA's mission revolves around science, service, and stewardship, and strives to predict climate changes, share their knowledge with others, and conserve and manage ecosystems. So again, in our shared facility building, this is really where we are going to be connecting with our community. In addition to bringing NOAA professionals into our school, because Slide has a career-based program, we really want to bring other mentors into our school to work one-on-one with students. So this is another place for students to connect with those professional mentors.
So keeping in mind the environmental aspect of Slide, we wanted to take advantage of the school's location and the environment of water. So by doing this, we are going to be installing a couple of sustainable systems such as geothermal heat pumps, a green wall system, kinetic flooring, solar panels, and wind turbines. So the whole purpose of installing geothermal heat pumps would be because we would use the water as a heat sink in the summer and a heat source in the winter, and that would cause us to rely on the relative warmth of the earth for the heating and cooling production. And this would also eliminate the need for separate furnace and air conditioning systems, and also leave free hot water heating during the summer months. And the whole purpose or the most beneficial aspect of the pumps is that they use 25-50% less electricity than conventional heating. And for the green wall system, we would install it near the restroom. And the way it operates is that it treats all of the gray water produced by the building. And the water travels to the top of the wall through a drip irrigation system after being pumped from a gray water collection tank.
For kinetic flooring, it would take 250 steps to generate 0.5 watt hours of electricity, or 500 steps per watt hour. Let's say we could capture 2,000 steps per day per student. For 800 students, this would generate 1,600,000 steps per day, which would generate to 3,200 watt hours per day. At 180 school days per year, that's 576,000 watt hours, or only 576 kilowatt hours per year. The kinetic flooring doesn't add that much to the energy generation. However, Slide High School still wants a system that's so sustainable so the kids can engage and be a part of the whole thing. So for the solar panels, our quantity will be 2625. The type will be Sharp Premium Solar Panels, which is 300 watts per panel. Each solar panel will be inclined to the south, facing the sun, so each solar panel will receive the most amount of sunlight to generate the most energy. Each solar panel will be at a tilted angle, which is 40 degrees. However, the roof itself is 13 degrees, but we will use custom racks for a steeper pitch. When will I see you again? All the panels together generate 875,244 kWh per hour, multiplied by 3.142, which equals 2,750,016 kBTUs per year. Another way to generate electricity on site is by wind power. Our wind turbines would be located adjacent to Lake Washington. The wind speed for that location is 6.2 miles per hour. The vertical axis wind turbines will operate in 6 mile per hour winds. Since our wind speeds are on the low end, we will assume each turbine would generate 2,000 kilowatts per hour. After all the calculations, we will need 30 wind turbines to generate the rest of the amount of energy Slide needs. There will be energy touchscreen dashboards at both of the entrances of Slide High School, which will provide students with the knowledge of how much energy is being used, and they can also become part of the energy reduction solution. We now assume that the energy use intensity is 18 kBTU per square feet per year. Originally, it's 20 kBTU per square feet per year. However, we use triple pane glazing at the windows and skylights and other insulation that help lower the value. The total area of the school is 163,287 square feet, multiplied by 18 kVTU per square feet per year, which equals 2,939,116 kVTU per year.
So Slide's total energy use intensity of all energy generation is roughly 3 million kVTUs, leaving us with 40,000 kVTUs in excess. So this means that the energy generated on-site is more than the energy demand of the building, making the school net positive.
So when we're coming up with the design of the school, we first think about what a typical school day would be like. We really want the design to be able to satisfy both students' physical needs as well as their intellectual needs. To address the physical needs, we concerned about students' safety and health. The building is divided into two, the student building and the shared building. And there are two separate entrances for the students and the public. So the student can use facilities of both of the buildings, but public can only gain access to the shared buildings. To take care of students' health, we're not using any red list materials that might cause harm to the students, and we're using materials that are easy to clean, such as polished concrete flooring. And also the open concept of the building enhances the ventilation. Structure-wise, the student building are designed to be long and narrow with curtain wall system at almost every side. So all the rooms can be located at the size of the building and be able to receive sufficient amount of sunlight. Research shows that increasing sunlight in classroom can cut down on absenteeism and improve test scores, and as well lower the cost of lighting. And there are lots of indoor green space, such as trees at the first floor hallway, as well as the second floor plaza. And as the statistics shows that plants help reduce stress and create a feeling of well-being. And also there's a roof garden at the top of the shared building, which students can plant crops. Coming up with the floor plan design, we believe in the principle of form follows function, in which teaching and learning should shape the building instead of vice versa. And the design should be warm and welcoming, which foster a sense of belonging and making students want to go to school on a typical Monday morning. So with that said, the area of the building is divided into five zones, namely the Think, Create, Discover, Impart, and Exchange zones. This allows a more effective teaching and student space to choose what they want to do.
The Think Zone has different types of rooms that support different types of thinking. Students can get inspired in this space by exploring on their own. The Create Zone is a space to let students cultivate their ideas by collaborating with others. The Discover Zone is where students can prove or test their theories and ideas. The Impart Zone is where students get to absorb new knowledge from others, whether it is from teachers, classmates, or people outside of school. The last one is the Exchange Zone. It is where the interaction with public happens. Other facilities included in the building are the administrative office, counseling office, nurse room, staff office, cafeteria, cafe, gym, weight room, career center, and the napping room.
A couple months ago, Kylie, Sabrina, Diana, and myself met up, all with interest in architecture and marketing, to design a high school of the future. Throughout this process, we worked together to bring our ideas to the table and compromise on what we believe is a winning idea. At the beginning of the design process, we created a Gantt chart laying out the pacing to complete all of our deliverables so that by the time of the deadline, everything is complete and in pristine condition. In preparation for the scope of this project, each group member began EPAC certification in order to gain additional knowledge about energy in buildings. We also met up with a mentor, Philip, who is an architect at NAC Architecture in Seattle. He met with us one out of our four group meetings per week. We also spent one day going down to his office in Seattle, where he showed us around his firm, showed us what they do in an architecture firm, as well as gave us a Revit tutorial. As for our day-to-day meetings, as I mentioned before, our group met up 4 times a week at Inglemoor High School. We began by brainstorming for the site, the education plan, the physical aspects of the building itself, as well as the energy aspects. And on our own, we kind of took over a leadership role in one of those 4 positions. Now, each day, we would also bring our own ideas to the table and discuss them as a group so that we could compromise on the best idea. As a whole, this project was a great opportunity for us to not only connect with individuals in our community, but also learn more about both the energy, the architecture, and the whole marketing side of designing. We really enjoyed this project and hope that you like it as much as we do.